chats with Susan Jack. I am Susan Jack, and I'm very happy to be with you here again today. So this is a class for our mature adult senior class. This is episode 5, so well done. I hope that you are tuning in. I hope that you're MMMing with me at home. For those of you that are just clicking on a random program, just be aware that this is a progressive dance technique. We work within the Margaret Morris method of dance, and things that you've learned in the first few episodes we'll be building on even more today. So if you're brand new, I highly recommend you going to episode 1, starting from there and then moving forward. For all of my students at home in Elmont, welcome back. I'm so happy to be here with you again today. Just a gentle reminder to work within your own body. Nothing should ever hurt or feel uncomfortable. You always have permission to modify the movement to best suit you or eliminate it altogether if need be. And also be aware of your space. So just working around your own living rooms, outside if you're able to, just being careful of your space and your footing. What's in store for you today? A little bit of dance, a little bit of movement, a little bit of work on body positioning, strengthening, balance, breathing, and feeling a little bit better. I hope that you are all still doing well. We're coming up to the end of April now. The sun is shining, it's a beautiful day, but we still have all these restrictions in place, so hopefully that's not dampening your spirits too much. Anyways, what we will do is we'll get started with our warm-up. So a chair for a warm-up if needed. If you prefer to stand beside a chair, that's completely fine. Again, working within your own body and making this work out for you, what you need for yourself. So you always have permission to go a little bit more if you need to, or a little bit less as well. Both are completely fine. Okay, let's get started with our warm-up. All right, sitting in your chairs, nice and tall, or standing, that's fine too. All right, just start with head, right and left. Center and left. Center, right, center, left. Center, tipping, ear to the shoulder and center, and left. Okay. Hold it here for a moment. Oh my gosh, that feels good. Up, center, same thing to the left. Hold it here for a moment. Good, and up, center. We're just gonna tuck the chin in. So, rolling down, and standing up, rolling down. Add the breath, breathing out. Once more. Good, shoulders, circles, right and left. Good, coming forward. You'll see I have an assistant again today, Mr. Porter. Good. He's happy to be stuck with me. We're gonna slow the tempo down. Circle back. Good, big reach, big stretch through your sides. Add the head if needed, if that feels comfortable. Good, coming forward. Where is Libby, you ask? She's on her bonus walk today. She needs it. All that puppy energy. Good. Both arms stretching up. Breathing in. Tight contraction. Nice and tight with the abdominals. Stretching up. Again. Breathe. Breathe out. One more. Good. We're going to do some side stretches. So both arms up. Right arm down. Relax and stretch. Oh, good. Same thing. To the left. Over, relax and stretch. I feel taller. Again, stretching up. To the right. Relax and stretch. And open. Last time. Good. Big breath out. Wonderful. Just a little work in the hip flexors. Just lifting up right and left. Right and left. Lift, lift, sitting tall, shoulders over the hip. Good. And rest. Right foot up, extend out, in, and back. That's it. Up, out, in, and back. Good. We're gonna add in some foot flexion. Flex, point, flex, point, flex, changing sides. Lift, extend, flex, point, flex, point, flex, changing side. Add the hands, lift, point, flex, point, flex, point, changing sides. Lift, extend, flex, as point, flex. Good. Just ankle and wrist rotations. Right foot, reverse it. Might be a little harder to standing up. Switching sides, left foot working. Good, reverse that. Good, hands coming to center. Open one. Expand through the chest, breathing out. Good, both hands swing to the right, right, and center. Left, center, right, center, and left. Good, just to shake out your arms. Standing up, we're gonna finish our warm-up standing beside your chair. Your chair is there for balance if you need it. Okay, we're gonna just start working through the feet, the knees, the hips a little bit more before we get going on our class. All right, ready? So just pressing through the feet, spreading your toes. Good, that's it. So press, press, and change. Press, change, press, and change. That's it. We're going to change things a little bit. We're going to roll off the foot, pointing to the ground. Your toe is the last thing to come off the ground. Again, your chair is there if you need it for balance. Good. If balance is okay, hands come up to the hips. Good. Coming up a little higher, calf or side of the knee. That's it. Now, if you want more of a challenge, we're going to swing in opposition to the lifted knee. That's it. We're going to add a little something if you wish. So up, release. Release the knees, release. That's only if it's comfortable for your knees. Good. Wiping back, so working through the hamstrings a little bit. Center, one, center, that's it. Good, we're gonna stretch through your calves a little bit, pressing the right heel to the floor behind you. I'm just gonna go in profile so you can see. Heel to the floor, linking your fingers. Oh no, that's part of our stretch. Sorry, we'll do that at the end of the class. Stay tuned. Good, so just lifting up, stretch, and back. There, that feels better. Good, changing sides. Put your left foot behind you, heel to the floor, feeling that stretch first. Arms coming up, lengthening through your body. That's it. Come up, and back. That's it. Good, changing sides. Right foot back once more. Again, your chair is there if you need it. We're going to work through the quadricep and the hip flexor. So, coming in and tuck, push that heel back. So the heel comes up, bend the knee, tuck the pelvis, push back. Tuck, push back. Tuck, changing sides. Left foot goes back. We're going to do the same thing. So heel comes off. Bend the knee, tuck the pelvis, pushing back. We just go a little smoother, bend and tuck, pushing back, bend and tuck, pushing back. Last one, bend and tuck. Good, just march. Bring the hands up, open. Good, one more up, and open. Good, grabbing your chair, working through the hips, swinging forward and back. Good, that's it. You go to wherever you're comfortable. If your balance is fantastic, you can just add a swing. That's it. Good, changing sides. Left foot working. working that left hip. Good. Good resting here, just tapping in and open. Working rotation through the hip, changing sides, in and open. Good, just take a breath in. Good, roll the shoulders two times. One, and two. Again, breath in. Good, two shoulder rolls. One, two, last one. One, and two. Good, just give everything a little wiggle there. Make sure you don't feel any tension in anywhere else of your body. That's it, and then just swing and tap. That's it. Tapping through the heel. Good. Do you feel warm? Are you ready to do some work? Okay. The very first exercise that we're going to be doing today is working on the walk and balance exercises that we did in the first week. So in the first week, we saw walk and balance from basic. Do you remember what that was? It feels like a lifetime ago. We had three parts. We had 8 walking steps, then we stopped and we closed in our normal standing position with our hands in second. We had 8 walking steps again for B, and we added in a leg lift, or we were connected with the ground. Do you remember C? Feet together, we had the extension and we were up on our toes. So we're moving on actually to yellow, to the third level. They have two parts to their exercises that are built off of your Greek positions. So a very similar format where we'll have 8 walking steps and then we're going to take a 9th step into a Greek position or a step with a leg lift. So I'm going to show you both of those. So I'm just going to go in profile. So you would start with your right foot. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. On 9, you take an extra step into your Greek position, first Greek position. And we hold that for 8 whole counts. Okay? So again, these are very, very challenging. I'm going to give you 2 options. And if you did episodes 2, 3, and 4, you'll know your options are shorter stride, keeping both feet flat to the floor, a gentle bend in the knees, still working the twist through the obliques, arms are still working in your first position. We hold that for 8 counts. If you are comfortable with your knees, you take that wider stride, up on both toes, flexing both knees, and your first Greek position arms, okay? Again, we hold that for 8 counts. From there, we walk with the back foot. Your left foot must start the second set so you can be balanced on both sides. You'd walk left, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, this time a Greek position with your left leg in front. Again, that same twist. Now you'll notice I'm twisting away from you, but my head always stays facing forward, okay? Again, we hold that for 8 counts. When we get into B, it's going to be very similar, but I'm going to take that step, and I'm going to either be my foot to my knee or resting to the floor at my instep. Again, you always have options. So with the right foot leading, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Picking up the left leg. This time I'm twisting away from you first. Again, your option 2 is staying connected with the ground, still working that twist, arms are in first position. Then you walk with your left foot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Picking up the right foot to finish and holding that for 8 counts. That's a tough balance to hold for 8 counts. So again, you pick the level that's good for you. You can stay at your instep here. You're still working balance. You're still working that twist with the Greek positions, okay? Shall we just try, we'll try 2 of each together before we put it with the music? Yes? Okay. So I'm going to just do a very small circle. If you have a coffee table, you can walk around it. Or you can just march on the spot. That works as well, okay? So the right foot starts with your 8 steps. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Hold, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Left foot leads. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And we hold, 5, 6, 7, 8. Part 2, right foot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, seven, eight, nine, stepping with the right foot, picking up the left, five, six, seven, eight, left, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, picking up the right foot this time, twisting to the right. How was that? Not too bad? Should we try it with the music? Yes? Okay, we're actually gonna do 4A, so right, left, and then 4B, right, left, okay? So again, you should be switching which foot's being lifted up or which Greek position you're in. Ready to go? Let's try. Ready? Right foot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. First Greek position, hold, breathe in, breathe out. Left foot, breathe in, breathe out. Left foot, Greek position. Same thing, right foot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Right foot, Greek position. Good, last one of A, left foot leading. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. B, right foot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Pick up the left leg. Left foot leads. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Good. One more right and left for B. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Good. Last one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Good. Rest. How was that for you? Balance? How was it? I'm working in carpet. On carpet, not in carpet. I guess my toes are in carpet. But I'm working on carpet, and it's much more difficult than the floors and surfaces we're used to be working on. So I've been working on my balance. So that's one of my opportunities from the last few months. Are we good to move on? We are going to go on to an exercise from the white level, from our second level, called posture walk. With posture walk, our goal is to eliminate our lumbar curve for just a short amount of time, strengthening all the muscles that support your lumbar region, good posture as well. Okay, so I'm actually gonna go in profile with this exercise so that we can do it together. You can kind of see what we're doing. And then we'll go together with music. So your right foot steps forward first. And when you step forward, you want to have most of your weight forward. Again, if you need a chair or something for balance, a fireplace mantle, a wall, anything like that is completely fine because we're working a little bit of balance as we're doing this exercise. So you're on your right foot. You want as much of your body weight forward as possible. If you feel like you're gonna fall forward, you're in the right spot. If this is really tricky for balance and you need to come back just a little bit and put a little bit more weight on the back toe, that's completely fine as well. You're always working within your body. So I'm on my right foot, I'm all the way forward with my thorax, and when I'm here, I'm gonna tuck my pelvis. And by doing that, I'm eliminating the lower curve of my body. Just rest your legs for a moment. Very often in our day, we get working, and we get this unnatural curve. So our goal here is to straighten out that curve just for a moment, get those muscles refocused, take some of the tension out of your back. So again, all your weight forward on your right foot, your thorax is forward, you've tucked in your pelvis. Now I wanna have a straight line from my toe behind me, right through that side of my body, up through my arms. So you have a nice diagonal line, and your right arm just comes out to the side for balance. So you have four counts to get there with your breath in. So 1, 2, 3, make sure to tuck 4. And then when we walk, 5, 6, close 7, 8. We do the same thing with the left foot. So left foot comes forward, thorax is forward, tucking in that pelvis, a nice straight line from your left side, from your toe, all the way up to your fingertips, and your other arm is out to the side for balance. Your head's gonna look up off that arm. It's a beautiful, beautiful line. Oh, sorry. And from there, we have two walking steps. 1, 2, and 3, 4. Okay, now, those of you in my class at home, what are you saying? What are you thinking? Keep your shoulders down, Susan. Yes, you're right. So this is a very easy exercise for as we're doing this lovely position, you think, oh, I'm gonna go more forward with my body. No, that's just your shoulder. So we'll make sure we stay nice and square through your shoulders. We're not reaching with that shoulder. We're reaching with our bodies. Okay, so this arm, your arms are there as frosting, okay? They're there, they play an important part, but it's not the leading role, okay? So let's try this with the music. Nice slow tempo. I'm gonna have to shorten my walking steps due to the space that I'm working in. You might have to do the same. So we'll just do 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm gonna walk on the spot. 5, 6, 7, 8. Walk into my next one. Just shorten my steps. Let's try with the music. Here we go. Good. Breath out. Tuck. We'll do one more breath like that. Getting the pelvis ready. Breathing in. Breathe out. Tuck. Right foot. Ready. Here we go. Breathing in. 2. Thorax forward. Tuck your pelvis. Walk. 5, 6, 7. Left. Same thing. Breathing in. Tuck that pelvis. Thorax is forward. 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm just going to take some time to turn around here. Breathing in. Breathe out. Good. Right leg. Once more. Breath in. 2, 3. Breath out. Good. Same thing again. Breath in. 2, 3, 4. Breath out. Good. One more little turn here. Let's do 2 more. Right and left. And then we'll stop. Breath out. Right foot. And go. Breath in. Thorax forward. Tuck your pelvis. Left foot, same thing. Big reach forward. Good, rest. How did you find that? Could you feel the work in your lumbar spine? Feel those muscles, they're working hard to help relax that curve. If at all in this class you'd like to repeat an exercise, I welcome you to hit stop, rewind, and go again. Just in order to keep kind of the flow of the class moving, I will keep going, but anytime you want to repeat something, you always have that, you have that option. And I can't stop you. Okay, moving on. We are going to do a breathing exercise. So this exercise is from Yellow. It's called Yellow Neck Rest and Upstretch Breathing. We're going to be doing A. So in this breathing, we're going to come through our first position. From here, we're going to flex our elbows and the hands come to rest behind your neck. So I've got little short arms, so if I was to put my hands on my neck, I'm going to break my line. So first position, flexing your elbows. So right now, just my fingertips touch. But if you can get your hands back there, that's the position. The second position, we turn our fingertips to the ceiling. We stretch all the way up. The third part, we open wide, expanding the lungs to the side. This is very similar to breathing progression B. Nope, breathing progression C. And from here, I'm going to bend up my elbows. My hands are going to come up through my fourth position. Backs of my hands slide down my ribcage. And on the last beat, I close. So again, the movements, and then we're going to add the breathing with it. So the hands come up to the side, palms facing forward, through first. Flex your elbows, resting behind your neck. Fingertips relax, stretch up to the ceiling. That's it, keeping your shoulders down. Don't let them reach up. Now we're gonna expand wide here, further expanding your lungs, and then backs the hands, come down and close. With the breathing, so we breathe in, 2, 3, 4. Breathe out, 2, 3, 4. A big breath in here, expanding through those lungs. Breath out. Okay. The head is going to follow the level of the hands. So breathing in here, we're neutral. When we breathe out, the head's going to follow the hands. When we breathe in, the head will come back to normal. And we breathe out, the head will go slightly down with the level of the hands. Okay, so if you find that you get dizzy at all during these deep breathing exercises that we do, you always have options. So you could do this exercise seated on a chair, number one. You could put a little space in between your feet. In our MMM exercises, our normal starting position is with our feet nice and tight. Sometimes that can throw our balance off, so if you want a little space so you're just under your hips and your pelvis, That's completely fine. But most importantly, back off on your breathing. Don't breathe as hard. Don't breathe as deeply, okay? Sometimes we're just not used to breathing that deeply, and it can make us a little bit lightheaded. Let's go with the music. We're going to start off slow. Just make sure that we have the proper motions. Then we'll add the breathing in a faster tempo. You ready? Here we go. Back out here. Breath in. You'll notice I have a little space between my feet as well. So we're gonna go slow first. Okay, don't worry about the breathing, just the arm positions. Good. Back of your neck, stretching, expanding. Stretching up to the ceiling, keeping your shoulders down. Good, that's a nice stretch. You should feel that in the back of your arms. Stretching wide. Good. First position, palms are facing the ceiling. And then we can come up and curl it down. And rotate and close. We're going to speed this up again. Just the arm movements. Back of the neck. Up. Good. Opening wide. Feel that stretch in your rib cage. Good. Let's add the breathing in now. If you haven't done it already, breathe in. Out. Good. Good. Let's try it again. Breathing in. When you breathe out, if you can, a little pelvic tuck is very subtle. Pelvic tuck again. Good. Again. Good. Good, and rest. Good job. So important to breathe deeply and ventilate those lungs. And this exercise that we just did really gives the expansion that you can do that. Okay, we're moving on. We're going to do an arm exercise today from the orange level called arm exercise A, B, and C, and D. That means we have four parts. So in this exercise, we're going to take the focus from the shoulder blades where we had that ripple motion in our last exercise that we did. We've done our diamond arm working throughout the full arm. We're going to work more the wrist and the forearm in this exercise. So we start, I should say first, we finish with our basic arm exercise here. I'm just going to open those hands up a little bit so they're in front of my hips. That's your starting position for orange. What we're going to do is we're going to add a wrist rotation. So I come out, I open up through my second position really, and I finish in my soup plate position. Okay, palms are to the ceiling. This is your first position. We just did this with that breathing. Elbows are flexed in, squeezing through your upper back. From here, I'm going to turn my wrists in. They're going to do their circle at the second variation, and we finish in a reverse diamond. So our diamond from our basic was palms facing. Now they're facing outside. From here, I open up through my second variation, back to soup plates. I turn in, around my second position again, a full circle back to my starting position. Can you feel this in your wrist yet? I can. We can do it again. So through second, soup plate, turn in, back to back. Open, soup plate, turn in the full circle. No shortcuts. I'm here. Good. Shake out. Head. If you want to add your head on this, we look right for the first one. You look up with the reverse diamond. You work, look left as you come down and down at your hands. And then you reverse. Second time through, you're looking left first. Part two, B. We're going to do single hands one at a time. So similar to yellow, to the first arm exercise, when we do the single arms, when you do a placement, you leave it there. So my right arm is going to circle and open to soup plate, and I leave it there while my left arm works. Soup plate. It's a little faster tempo. Up and up. Right arm comes down. One and two and three and four. Of course, you're not balanced. We have to do it with the left arm leading. So you have one. Now right. Up left. Up right. Down with the left. One. And two, three, and four. Good so far? Shake out. We haven't even added music yet. I can feel this in my wrists. on the end, the half beat before part three, before C, we bring your right arm up. So we're going to be working opposite. So I'm going to open up both of my hands. I meet in soup plates. I turn them in. Now my right arm comes down, my left goes up. So you open, meet in soup plate, turn in, one down, one up. If you are good with this motion and you want to add the head will always look over the down shoulder. So not looking straight down. So I don't want to see the top of your head. We want to see you in profile looking down. Neutral, down. On the very last one, you bring that right arm back. Part D. Anybody know? Lynn? Mary? Janice? You guys know? We're going to release the knees and we're going to dance this exercise, this last part, with the single arms going to the right. So we have right, right up leading, and left, up right, and left. Now I'm on the left, but I want to be back on the left again to come down. So I'm going to do a little cheater change of weight, and then right back to the left, and right, left, and right. Now, same thing. I want to go right again. I'm going to repeat exactly that. So I need to have that cheater change of weight. Left, right, left, right, and left. Same cheater movement. Right, left, and right, left, and right. And to finish, I bring that right foot back in. Complicated? Yes, very complicated. That's why this is a progressive technique. So again, if you need to rewind and go over any part of that, you can certainly do that. But we're going to do this now with the music. All set? Here we go. Okay, starting positions just in front of your hips. Both arms together. Breathing in. Good, looking to the left this time. Right arm leading, and what? Two. Down with the right. Same thing, left arm leading. Left arm comes down. Right arm up. Here we have this mixed matched one. Middle. Right arm down, looking over that right side. Center. Good, that's it. Good, repeat again. Center. And down. Last time. What's next? Change of weight. Good, yes, to the right. And right. Soft through the knees, really dance that. Add a side stretch. Down on the left. And left again. Good. Good. Right again. And right. Good. Left. Left once more. And left. Good. And close. Yes. Well done. Shake out those hands. Good stuff. Can you feel that in your wrists? That is really strong work. You've got all these rotations. We do a little bit of that in our warm-up, but that's really focusing on those. Okay, we're gonna grab your chairs. We're gonna do some chair work, starting with sitting coordination. Okay, so a quick review. Hopefully this isn't new to anybody, because if it's new for anybody, it's very overwhelming. So this is an exercise we did in episode 1 and episode 3, so it should be review. But again, if you need to, you can stop, rewind, go over some of the moves if you need to. Right arm starts, wrong exercise. We have the clap for the introduction. So you've got clap, both hands down, lift right, lift left, clap, and second. We have pointing and flexing. So I'm going to stay straight on. If you're able to and you want the extra challenge, you can turn your left foot pointing to the right wall. Then you have point, flex, point and flex. Come back to your center. You may stay straight or you may take your right foot to the left wall. Point, flex. Back to your center. Clap. Slide your feet forward. You have flexion. Right, left, right, left. Clap. Coming back. Plantar flexion this time. One, two, three, four. We repeat the introduction. Clap. Down. I'm going to lift my left side first this time. Left, right, clap, and second. Now, instead of swiveling, I'm going to stay facing forward. My chair doesn't swivel very well. So we've got clap, extend. Now we're going to bend knee and elbow. So bend, stretch, bend, stretch. If you can, really try to get a good twist with that back arm. And stretch, flex, stretch, flex, stretch. The same pattern, sliding forward. This time we're working ankle inversion, eversion, same with your wrists. So we've got right over left, left over right, clap, slide back, left this time, right this time. Next we go into wrist and ankle circles. And if it's comfortable and you want to add the head, you can. I feel restricted in my neck in this movement, in that position, so I don't add it. Well, this side is okay. I'm unbalanced. From here, we have your right hand up, pointed in. Same thing left. We flex and point, flex and point. Pushing down right, pushing down left. Drawing up, push back. Drawing up, push back. A big dramatic circle with the music, finishing in second. Now we're gonna add in arm swinging and arm circling. We've got back, swing forward, back, forward, back. Nothing with the legs. There, just look pretty. Forward, back. Next we have arm circles. Circling one and two. Same thing on the other side and back. One and two. From here, feet extend forward, arms extend up. So stretch and forward. The right foot comes back, the hands, palms facing the floor, twisting to the right, bodies forward. Bringing in the left foot, twisting left, sitting up, twisting right, twisting left, in the air, right and left. We repeat that. This time we're going to bring the left foot back first, then the right, twisting left, right, in the air, left and right. A big dramatic circle. What's left? We've got one last sequence. Anybody know? Arm exercise from basic. We did this week one. Adding in the leg. So you lift, extend, cross, push down. If you want, you can add the head movement. So the head starts with the right leg up, looking right. When you extend, look left. When you cross, look up and down with the hands. Last left, extend, cross, and down. We have, this is from red, I believe. Push one, two, three, four, a big dramatic circle at the end, clap and finish. That's your ta-da movement. So again, a lot to this exercise. It's actually 2.5 minutes long, a little bit over. So it's a long exercise to learn. In our classes, we break it down and learn it week to week, but you have the option of pause, rewind, and play. So you, again, if you need to, if not, stay seated. I'll be right back with the music. All right, here we go. Introduction. Clap and down. Lift right, lift left, clap and second. Point and flex. Point, flex, point, flex. Same thing. Point, flex, point, flex. Sliding forward. We have dorsiflexion. Good. Coming back. Plantar flexion. Right, left, right, left. Back to the introduction. I'm going to lift left first. One, two, clap, and second. Knee and elbow. Bend, stretch, good. Bend, stretch, sliding forward. Right over left, and left. Good, come back. That's it. Left, left. We have wrist and ankle circles. Circle one and two. Good, head. Other side. Circle one and two. Right hand. One, two. Flex, point. Flex, point. Push down. Push down. Up. Good, big circle. We have swinging and circling next. Here we go. Clap, stretching back. Swing. One, two, three, four. Good. Circles now. Stretch back. Circle one and two. Again. Stretch back. Circle. Circle. Stretch both up. Come forward. Back right and left. Twist right. Left in the air. Good. Again. Stretch. Back left and right. In the air, left. Good, big circle. Home stretch. Diamond arm exercise with your legs. If it's too much, drop the legs, just do the arms. Left. Last one, you got it. Good. And diamond, push right, push left, big circle. Yes, good work, good work. Stay seated. Well done, such a great exercise. It really, the name really suits, sitting coordination. There's a lot of work in there to get it just right. Okay, moving on, we're going to go on to an exercise from the white level called Bending B. We've done bending A already. That's one where we come forward, we come up to a circle, we bend side to side. So bending B would be done kneeling, but we're gonna do it sitting, don't you worry. But we're gonna make it double time slow. So instead of coming forward over 6 beats, we're coming forward over 12 beats, and our side movements will be over 6 instead of 3. So we're slowing everything down, including the breathing. So nice, slow, gentle breathing. Starting position is the same. So shoulders are down, arms are lifted. You have not 12 counts to come down. We're gonna come down over 10 counts and hold for 11 and 12 with your breath out. So you're coming forward. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So just resting on your lap, your legs. If you're flexible and you want to go straight to the floor, you may do so, but again, working within your own body. So 10 counts to get down here, hold 11, 12. We slowly start to uncurl from underneath, using your abdominals to help you come back to upright. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is different. In A, we're to a circle, palms are facing forward. In B, where everything is to the floor, including my palms. Right hand is slightly over top of the left. Okay, shoulders are down. Don't let them sneak up. Now we're going to go down to the side. 1, 2, 3, and then slightly forward. 4, 5, 6. Relax and gather the arms, still having the right hand on top. Until now, we come to straight. Then the left goes on top because we're going to the left side. 1, 2, 3 to the side, and then forward. 4, 5, 6. Just a little relax and stretch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Back to my starting position. Breathing out, coming forward. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Rounding through that back. 7, 8, 9, 10, hold 11, 12. Sitting up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This time my left hand's on top. Breathing out as we go to the side. Breathing out. 2, 3, keep breathing out. Breathing in as you're uncurling. 6, right hand on top on beat 1, breathing out, breathing out, breathing in as we finish. So this is very arm intensive. Having your arms up working like this for so long is very challenging. So you can certainly do this exercise relaxing your hands on your lap, coming forward, uncurling from underneath, rounding to the side and forward. You can still do this without having the extra strain of your arms in the air, if you need to. Shall we try it with the music? Yes? I'm gonna go to MMM music for this one because I think it has the right nuances and timing. Here we go. All right, take a breath in. Okay, shoulders down, arms are lifted. So 10 counts to come forward, slow. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Relax your neck, breathing in. 6, shoulders down, 8, 9, 10. Good, to the right, breathing out. Out, 2, 3, and 4, breathing in.
slowly uncurling.
Good, left hand on top. Breathing out. Breathing in. Good, again. From underneath. Left hand on top. 10. Good to the left. Head follows. Breathing out. And forward. Breathing in. Left hand stays on top. Good. Changing sides. Right. Arms.
How did you find that?
Strenuous? Yes, it is. I do find it a little bit strenuous for my upper body, but you're really working through the lower back, through the sides with those stretches. It's a very good one to release and relax all those muscles. Good stretching. Okay, we're going to work on a leg circling balance. So standing up now. So with your chairs, sorry, partner. Okay, so standing beside your chairs, we are going to do leg circling balance from the white level. So in this balance, we're working through the hip and we're working rotation as well as stabilization on the supporting leg. It's very important in this one that your body stays upright. So all the work is coming through your leg. At no point do we lose our frame or kind of teeter to hold the balance. So if you feel like that's happening, drop your foot and go on the floor. So we're going to work through two stages, maybe three times on one side, and then we'll reset to the other leg. So do this with me now at home, without any music first, and then of course after we'll add it all into music. So the right leg is going to draw a circle. So first on the floor, it's going to open to the side. You have a little movement where it has to go up and over in that hip joint to stay square, and it extends to the back and close. Option two is with your hand on the chair and one arm working together with the leg, the side, up and over, and close. Option three, staying connected with the ground, both arms working. So now that I have both arms working, I'm going to really feel the connection through my right leg, my right toe, all the way through my left arm. That's where your strength comes through your body. Your body helps with this with good posture. Option four, we relax and stretch up, and now you're in the air, now I'm going to wobble over to the side, up and over that hip joint. It's a little bit more pronounced now that I'm standing, and close. I had lots of wobbles going on there. Balance is difficult at every stage. So again, your first is on the floor, just with the foot. Second is arm and foot working together. Third, on the floor, both arms working. And last, we build up to no foot on the floor. Everybody change sides. I've moved my chair so I don't end up kicking any walls. All right, option one, if you remember, staying connected with the ground, no arms. Sliding forward, going to the side, up and over in that hip joint, stretching to the back, and close. Option two, same arm, same leg working, to the side, open to the back, and close. Option three, still staying connected with the floor. Open to the joint, to the back, and close. The fourth option, here we go. Opening to the side, up and over in that hip joint to the back, and close. Four options. So we're going to start low on each one and build up. It will be slower with the music, but it's very important that we use our breathing. So we're breathing in, keep breathing in, breathing out, as we close and relax. The breath will help this, as well as good posture. So if I'm just working my leg here, not much is happening. If I'm here and I'm lifted and expanded, that's gonna help me to lift and hold the balance. Strong core, strong supporting leg muscles, strong working muscles. Shall we go with the music? Come so that your right leg is gonna be working first. We'll do four-ish. We'll stop, reset, and do the other side. Here we are. Use the introduction. Breath out. So No arms at first.
Sliding forward.
Breathe in. Keep breathing in. Breathing out.
Add the same arm with the leg. Breath in, extend forward. Open to the side. Breath out, extend back. Add the second arm if you like. Breath in. Good, and out. Then you have the choice to come a little higher if you wish. Good. Now I want you to do two more. Pick your favorite one. Of course, you're just fatiguing the same leg right now, so this last one will be very difficult. I'm gonna go to the floor. I'd rather do it with proper posture than a whole bunch of wobbles. Good, rest. How did you find that? The fifth and the sixth one were a surprise. You're welcome. But again, just really working the stabilization of the supporting leg and then also all those muscles that are working. So let's switch spots. I'm gonna move my chair so that way our left leg can be working. All set?
Here we go.
Start with your breath. Add a breath out. Leg only just to begin. Sliding forward, breathing in. To the side, breathing out. And close. Arm and leg. Breathing in. Feeling that stretch expansion, lift. Good, both arms. Breathing in. Expand and lift. Coming up a little bit higher. If you like, it's optional. Open to the side. Good, we have two more, your choice. Breath in. Finish on the floor like I did this other side. Breath in. And open. Good. To the back. And close. Good. Rest. Just give your legs a little bit of a wiggle there. How did you find that? Again, really strong, hard work for the supporting leg, for those rotational muscles that are involved in that circle motion, and of course that good posture to have you upright. Right. We're all done with the chairs. We're going to put those away for today. So just off to the side. Okay, so now we're coming to the part where we're going to do a little choreography, and it's one that some of my students have seen before, so I hope you recognize and enjoy it. And some of the moves from today's class are in it, as well as one exercise from a little bit ago, water wheel. So this the dance is called Moln, M-O-L-N, beautiful piece of music. It's one of my favorites. So for the introduction, we start with yellow neck rest breathing. So we did this in class today. 1, 2, 3, 4. Stretching up, opening down, and close. From there, I'm just going to add on two more arm positions. Coming to our second position, but I'm going to leave my backs of the hands to you. My palms are facing backwards. I stretch up to my second variation, and then I just turn and relax down. We're going to start with a water wheel. Okay? So I think I'd like my left hand to start working first. So normally we start with your right hand working, but I want to change that. So left hand circles first. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. From here, I'm just going to kind of pivot and go right into that posture walk that we did today. So my left arm extends up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then I step to the left with my right arm working. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Just a little pivot turn for your posture balance. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm just kind of walking on the spot. I think we might have time to do that two different times. So shall we try just with music to there? Yes? Okay. 2, stretching up, opening wide. That's it. And down. Second position, palms facing backwards. Good. Up. And open. Exhale, big exhale, little pause. Left hand working, step into the right. Little circle. A little tiny pivot, posture walk. Walk and walk. Now stepping left, the right arm working. Pivot, posture. Good. Let's just go right into water wheel. And same thing with the right arm. Good, feet together. Relaxing forward. Open extend back. Gentle stretch. Good, rest. Good. So, just a quick recap. So we have our water wheel with the left arm working. We do a little tiny pivot. That left arm stretches all the way up for our posture walk. Just two steps, facing back to forward. Your right arm does your water wheel. Again, just that little pivot. The right arm extends up for posture walk with our two steps facing forward. And then doing the full water wheel. So left arm and right arm together. This is that limber A. Do you remember that? Extend and lower. Now, just getting yourself back a little bit so you have room to come forward. So we're just gonna do a walk and tap. So one, two, three, and tap. One, two, three. My hands are just gonna cross and open. Now, I'm gonna do a similar posture walk, coming forward, but I'm gonna add in a side bend. So, stepping with your right foot, coming forward, I'm gonna stretch up to the right. One, two, three, four, walk one, and two, left, two, three, four, walk, and walk. I'm going to do the same water wheel, but a little faster tempo. So circle, I'm using my right arm this time, I don't know if you caught that. Together, open, in, and stretch. We add that all in. Yes? Here we go. From the beginning. Two. Stretch up. Two. Good. Open. Good. Turn and relax. And just pause, head comes up, left arm works first, circle, big stretch, pivot turn, left arm stretches up, posture walk, walk, one, and two, right arm circles, step left, right arm stretches up, posture walk, facing back to forward, good, left arm circles, nice and slow. You're exhaling into the music. Good, feet together. Step back. Gently bend. Good. Getting to your corner, to the back of your room. Two, three, cross. One. Good. We have posture walk, adding in that side stretch. Walk and walk. Stretching left, stepping left. Good. A quicker water wheel. This way. And left arm. The last little bit that we're going to add in is a little side tap. So it's similar to what we did in our class. So we finished here. I'm going to go this way, only because this is the room I have right now. So I'm going to cross with my left foot. One, two, three. Yes, left foot. So you've got left, right, left, tap, and then the right foot's going to cross over. Right, left, stay here. You're just going to relax and stretch to first position. Flex your back knee, and we draw it into soup plate, okay? Then, using your front foot, right, left, right, tap, left, right, left, relax to first position, and soup plate. If your balance is crazy, and you want to be up on the toes for that, you certainly can, and then you're just flexing the back knee into a slight back bend. It's a really beautiful position. Okay, so again, that part. So we finished here and stretch. So crossing over with the left foot. You've got left, two, three, tap, right. Right, two, three, and stay. Relax and stretch to first position. Bend the back knee. Again, if you want to stay flat feet, you certainly can. The front foot's going to work, your right foot. Right, left, right, tap, left, right, left. Relax and stretch and soup plate. There might be one more water wheel in there, but you know that already. So from the top, we have the neck rest for the introduction. There and there. We have the water wheel, left arm starts. I circle there, relax and stretch, do the posture walk, walk and walk. The right arm, same thing, into the posture walk, walk and walk. We have the slow water wheel to finish, stretch. Then we have the transition to get us back so that you can come forward with the right foot, posture walk with the side bend. That's actually from yellow. Same thing left, walk and walk. A quick water wheel, right arm working. It's the same as what we did before, just faster. Good, left arm, left foot crossing over. Cross, two, three, tap. Cross, cross, stay hold. Relax and stretch and flex. It's slow in the music, now the right foot. One, two, three, tap. One, two, three, relax and stretch. From the top, all set? Here we go. Good, stretching up. Opening wide, that's it. Through second position, second variation, and relaxing. Pause in the music. Left hand working first, a big circle. Add the head in. Pivot turn. Posture walk. One and two. Right arm working. Pivot turn. Right arm stretches up. Left arm working once more. Your transition, crossing the wrists, and opening them. You can add a leg lift if you wish. Good. Posture walk, adding in the side stretch to the right. Walk and walk. That's it. Left. Walk. Walk. Right arm works. Left arm. It's faster tempo. Crossing over, left foot, left, two, one, two, stay. Relax and stretch. Into soup plate. Good. Right leg. One, two, three. Stretch. One, two, three. First. That's it. Good. Rest. Well done. That's 2 minutes of that piece of music. Very good job. Okay, I think we're going to leave it there for today. So if you would like to at any time, you can rewind, start from the beginning of that choreography. You can go back to the beginning of the class. I hope that some of you are repeating these classes as well. It's getting harder and harder to get these episodes made for you. But I'm still committed. I'm still doing my best. So we are going to do spinal mobility, and then we'll do a little bit of a stretch just to finish our class today. All set? So spinal mobility, we end every set episode, every class when we're together, we end this way. So follow along, good breathing. Here we go. So feet are together, knees are relaxed. We've got a double hip movement, working lumbar spine, breathing in. again.
Breath in.
Good, tucking under, releasing your left knee, singles.
Good, oh, I feel bad.
Good,
forward and back.
Rotations, right hip back, left and singles. One, two, three, double right, double left. Hip lifting, right foot, right hip is just lifting ever so much. Singles now, one, two, three, and we close. Stepping out, feet are parallel. Only upper spine working, your thoracic spine here. Singles now, one. Good, rounding forward.
Oh, always my favorite,
extending back. Singles now, breathing out, in. Rotations, keep your hips nice and square. Twist through your upper body. Singles now, one. Good, lateral flexion, down to the right, and to the left. Now your singles, one, two, three, four, and we close. Fabulous job, well done. Very good to stretch out our spines and all the muscles that work within them. Okay, just a gentle stretch for you before you're on to the rest of your day. Taking a breath in. Breath out. Good. And rolling the shoulders. One more. And roll the shoulders. Good. Just going to turn it down just a little bit more. I'd like you to take your right foot behind you, stretching that heel to the floor. This is where it was earlier today. Just jumping straight to the stretch and the cool down. Linking your fingers and stretching forward. So making sure that both of your feet are pointing forward. Don't let that back hip turn out. Everything stays forward. If you want more of a stretch, you can flex more on that front knee or widen your stride. Just rounding through your upper back, getting a nice good stretch there. Oh, that feels good. And relaxing your arms, lifting up on that back toe, flexing that knee to the floor, tucking the pelvis in, feeling the stretch, your hip flexor and your quadricep. Thank you for dancing with me today. I appreciate you hitting play and inviting me into your home. Good, and just give that a little shake. Left foot goes back, same thing. Heel to the floor, again, making sure your feet are pointing forward. Opening up through your chest, you can draw those elbows back here. If you want, you can link your fingers, roll your shoulders up and down, back. Releasing your arms up on that back toe, flexing that knee to the ground, tucking through the pelvis. That's it. Good, and just giving that a little wiggle. Stretching through our shoulders, they got work today. Keeping your shoulders down, pulling your right arm across, head looks over that shoulder if you'd like. Breath in, breathe through your stretches. Same thing with your left arm, it comes across, you can grab, gently pull it, head looks over that left shoulder. This is the side I feel a lot more, carry a lot of tension in this shoulder. Everywhere. Good, and releasing that down. Let's stretch through the hips a little bit. So pushing your right hip to the wall. That's it. If you need to for balance, you can cross over to stabilize, or you can just stay at your instep, your choice. We worked a lot of hip muscles in with that leg circling balance, so this is a very good one to stretch all that out. Bring your right arm up to the ceiling, getting a nice stretch through your side, all the way through that hip. That's it. Making sure to keep that shoulder open at the top. That's it. I can feel this. Can you feel that? Good. And relaxing that. Same thing, pushing your left hip to the wall. Again, you can just relax your right foot, or you can cross in front for balance. You have choices. Yep, I can feel that side too. We worked those today. between the alternate half knee bending, making sure to keep that shoulder open. Between the half knee bending and the leg circling balance, we have a good class today. I hope you enjoyed it.
Good, and relax. Just coming in and opening the shoulders. Good, we have one muscle left to stretch, and that's your hamstrings. So taking your right foot forward, heel to the floor, tucking your pelvis to the wall behind you, and sitting back. That's it. Good, same thing on the other side. Left foot forward, tucking your pelvis back to the wall behind you. Wonderful. Good, coming back to center. Just a breath in. And hands to the side, breath out. Roll your shoulders once more. And again, a breath in. And a breath out. Roll your shoulders. Wonderful. Again, thank you for coming and dancing with me for today. Thank you for hitting play and inviting me into your home. I hope you enjoyed this episode, episode 5, I can't believe it. Onward to episode 6 for next time. I hope you'll tune in. I hope for this short time that we were together, you were able to breathe, to move, feel your body moving, enjoy the music, enjoy my company. I'm certainly thinking of you every time I'm filming these. I miss you guys. I hope that you're all safe, and I hope that we'll be able to connect in person and see each other really soon. Until then, I wish you a fabulous day, a fabulous May. It's just around the corner. And know that I am with you in MMM. Take care, everybody.